Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're going to be talking about ignition switches, and more specifically, the signs and symptoms and how to diagnose a faulty or bad ignition switch. If your car isn't starting and is having a no-crank situation, one of the most common causes is a bad ignition switch. However, there are also a number of other components that can cause a no-crank, no-start situation. So in this video, we're gonna go ahead and jump into how an ignition switch works, what some of the signs and symptoms of a bad one are, and then I'm gonna go ahead and walk you through a few diagnostic steps to determine whether the issue is with the ignition switch or whether it's with another potential problem on your car. So first off, the term ignition switch might be somewhat confusing, but all that's really referring to is the keyhole that you put your key into, which you then turn to turn your vehicle on. The ignition switch is an electrical component, and it has a bunch of wires that go to it that basically feed current or voltage from the battery to various different systems in your car. So ultimately, if your ignition switch goes bad, what happens is when you turn your key to the on position, it might not be sending voltage from the battery to the systems that are required for your car to actually start. First off, I do want to note that if your car cranks, then your problem's not going to be with your ignition switch. If your ignition switch is not working, the car will not crank. And so if your car does crank, you can go ahead and eliminate this as a potential problem from your list. With that out of the way, let's go ahead and talk just a little bit more in depth about how an ignition switch works. As I mentioned, it basically controls electrical currents from the battery. So how this works to start your car is you put your key into the ignition and then you turn it to the on position. What that does is sends voltage to the starter and to the starter solenoid, which gives the starter power to be able to turn the engine over and cause the engine to crank and start. So if you have a bad ignition switch, what happens is the starter motor doesn't get the voltage that it needs to be able to turn the motor over to get it to start. But as I mentioned earlier on, there are also a few other things that can cause a problem like this to happen as well. And that would be an issue with your battery or an issue with the starter or the starter solenoid, in addition to a potentially faulty ignition switch. And so with there being a couple different components that can cause a no start, no crank situation, let's go ahead and talk about some of the signs and symptoms that you'll notice that are gonna be more specific to a problem with the ignition switch rather than a problem with your battery or the starter motor. The two things that you'll wanna keep an eye out for that are gonna point you directly to your ignition switch is going to be, one, going to be an issue with your key and not having the ability to turn your key easily or the ability to pull your key out of the keyhole. And then a second thing would be the accessories like your car lights and your radio and your air conditioning not turning on when you turn your key to the on position of the ignition switch. Now, you might not have an issue with turning your ignition key and all of your accessories like your radio might turn on, but you still could potentially have a bad and faulty ignition switch. So let's go ahead and talk about diagnostic steps to determine whether the problem's with your battery, with your starter or starter solenoid, or whether it's actually with the ignition switch. So the first step in any diagnostic process for a car is to check for any check engine lights. While I did say that there are three things that could cause a no crank, no start, there are a few other things like a bad crankshaft position sensor that could do this as well, but something like that would give you a check engine light, so you would have an engine code that would point you directly to that problem. So before jumping into anything else on this list, it's important to go ahead and read your codes and see if there is anything stored in your engine's computer that can point you in the right direction. After that, the next best thing to do is to check all of your fuses and relays, and more specifically, any fuses specific to the starter. And most cars also have a starter relay as well. And so it's worth it to check that because the problem could just be with a small $2 or $3 fuse rather than a larger component. After that, I would also check your battery cables just to make sure there's no corrosion around them, to make sure they're making proper contact with the battery. So if we assume you have no engine codes, no issues with your battery cables, and no issues with your starter fuses or relay, then the next step from here is to check your battery voltage. If your battery is dead, dead or isn't holding enough voltage, then it's going to cause any one of these symptoms to where your car doesn't start, your lights don't turn on and so forth. And so making sure you've checked the battery so that we can cross the battery off the list. Then the next step is going to be the starter and the starter solenoid. When you take your key and turn your key to the on position, you'll notice that you hear a whirring noise coming from the engine. That's the sound of the starter motor. So typically, if you hear that sound, then your starter motor is at least working and functioning to some degree. If you don't hear that noise at all, then that means that you're probably not getting electrical current to the starter, or your starter motor is completely dead. To determine which one of those it is, you can take a multimeter to the starter to determine whether the starter and starter solenoid are actually getting current. If they are getting current and your car still isn't starting, then you have a dead starter motor. But if it's not getting current, then your problem is going to be with the ignition switch. Another thing that you can try doing as well is jumping your car directly from the starter motor. And if jumping your car directly from the starter motor works, that's going to typically mean that you have a working starter motor, but that your starter solenoid is not getting enough voltage, which is going to point you in the direction of a faulty ignition switch. And then if you want to skip all of those other things and just jump right to the ignition switch as well, you can take a circuit tester to the ignition switch to test the ignition switch and make sure that that's working properly. That's going to be a good diagnostic process to follow right there. Make sure it's not the battery, make sure it's not the starter motor itself, and then from there, by process of elimination, you can go ahead and jump into the ignition switch and test problems there. Ignition switches are relatively inexpensive, but testing your battery voltage and testing your starter is also very easy as well. And so it's worth it to put a little bit of effort into diagnostic steps here, just so that you don't end up throwing money at a new battery or a starter or even a new ignition switch when you don't need it. Anyways, guys, I hope you found this video helpful. Hopefully you're able to do a bit of diagnostics and figure out whether you have a bad ignition switch or not. If you guys appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for our future content.